गुड मॉर्निंग डियर चिल्ड्रन. चिल्ड्रन, इन टुडेज जीके सेशन वी लर्न अबाउट फेस्टिवल्स ऑफ इंडिया. चिल्ड्रन, यू मस्ट बी नोइंग दैट इंडिया इज़ अ लैंड ऑफ फेस्टिवल्स. दीज फेस्टिवल्स आर सेलिब्रेटेड बाई द पीपल ऑफ इंडिया ऑफ डिफरेंट कास्ट, रिलीजन्स एंड रीजन्स. एंड वी एज इंडियंस together celebrate these festivals with full joy and enthusiasm. Among these festivals, some are religious festivals, some of them are based on seasons, and some of them are celebrated across the nation as national festivals. So in today's session, children, we learn about the different festivals celebrated in our country. So let us begin our session. Here, first you'll have to learn that there are three types of festivals in our country. Number one, national festivals. Number two, religious festivals. And number three are the harvest festivals. We'll elaborate all these three festivals one by one. Okay, the first one is the national festivals. So what are national festivals? Festivals which are celebrated by the entire nation are called national festivals. So national festivals are Republic Day, Independence Day and Gandhi Jayanti. To cut short, we have three national festivals: Republic Day, Independence Day and Gandhi Jayanti, that is celebrated by the entire nation. Okay, as you know that Republic Day is celebrated on 26 January, Independence Day on 15th August, Gandhi Jayanti on 2nd of October. Okay, let us know about all the three national festivals of country one by one. Independence Day. Why we celebrate Independence Day as national festival? Let us know. India became independent on 15th August 1947 from Britishers. So to celebrate this independence, we celebrate Independence Day of our country every year on 15th of August. The Prime Minister of our country hoists the flag at Red Fort in Delhi and gives a speech. And the entire nation on their own hoist the national flag in respect of the country and sings national anthem. Various cultural programs are organized at the school and college level. Okay, then comes the Republic Day. India became a democratic republic on 26th January 1950. So we celebrate it as Republic Day. We gained our constitution on 26th January 1950 and we became a democratic republic on this day. So we celebrate every year on 26th January as our Republic Day. The main function is held at Rajpath. A special part is taken out. A special parade is taken out by the armed forces. So, on 26th January, special parade is held at Rajpath, and our Prime Minister, President, and various other official members, officers, politicians and various other personalities of our country and the other countries visit this parade at Rajpath. Okay. The next come is Gandhi Jayanti. As you know that Mohandas Karamchand Gandhi is known as our father, or the father of our country is Mahatma Gandhi. His full name is Mohandas Karamchand Gandhi. He is also known as the father of the nation. And to celebrate his birthday, that is on 2nd of October, we celebrate it as Gandhi Jayanti every year. He always believed in ahimsa and fought against the British without violence. So Gandhiji has always loved his people, and he was never interested in violence or doing fights or quarrels. Okay, so he said, "Be the change you want to see in the world." He always favored this tagline that if you want to change the world, first you have to change yourself. Okay, so every year on his birthday, we celebrate it as Gandhi Jayanti, and it is celebrated on 2nd of October. Okay, then comes the second part of the festivals. They are religious festivals. India is a land of many religions. So we have many religious festivals that are celebrated with joy across the country. Few of them are Diwali, Holi, Dashehra, Durga Puja, Raksha Bandhan, Christmas, Eid ul-Fitr, Guru Purab, and many more. So basically, religious festivals are the festivals celebrated by a particular religion across the nation. I have already named that religious festivals are Christmas, Diwali, Holi, Dashehra, Durga Puja, Raksha Bandhan, Janmashtami, and many more like this. Okay, so let us know about each festival one by one. The first one is our favorite, Diwali. Diwali is also known as Festival of Lights. It is celebrated because on this day, Lord Rama returned to Ayodhya after 14 years in exile. Diwali is also known as Festivals of Light. Okay, so our favorite festival is Diwali. I'm sure it is yours too. It is celebrated because Lord Rama came back to Ayodhya after the exile of 14 years. People decorate their homes so that Goddess Lakshmi come to their house. We perform Ganesh and Lakshmi Puja and decorate our house with various lamps and diyas. Okay? And also people burst crackers on this day. Okay? Then the next festival is Holi. As you know that Holi is the festival of colors, and it is mostly celebrated in North India. People all over the country celebrate this color by playing colors, give sweets, visit relatives' place, and give happiness to each other. Okay? Then the next one is Dashehra. This Dashehra is celebrated as the day on which Lord Rama killed Ravana. So why Dashehra is celebrated as the mark of victory of good over the evil? Because on this day, Lord Rama killed the evil Ravana. It is also known as Vijay Dashmi. Next, Durga Puja. It is mainly celebrated in West Bengal with great pomp and show. It is celebrated for 9 days where Goddess Durga is worshipped in each and every home, followed by Dashehra on the 10th day. Next one, Guru Purab. Guru Purab is the festival celebrated by the Sikh community or the Sikh religion. It is celebrated as the birthday of their 10th Guru, Guru Nanak. Okay, so their 10th Guru, Guru Nanak, Guru Angad, Guru Amar Das, Guru Ram Das, Guru Arjan, Guru Har Gobind, Guru Har Rai, Guru Har Krishna, Krishnan, Guru Tej Bahadur, Guru Gobind Singh and Guru Granth Sahib. So these days are known as Guru Purab or Guru Puja. The next one is the festival celebrated by the Muslim religion is Eid al-Fitr. Muslims celebrate Eid al-Fitr and Eid al-Juha. It is followed by a month of, it is during the month of Ramzan, Muslims fast from sunrise to sunset. So Eid is celebrated after keeping fast of 1 month in the month of Ramzan. Okay? Eid al-Fitr is the festival of Muslims. Then the last one comes, harvest festivals. Harvest festivals are basically celebrated at the harvest of different crops across various states and various regions of the country. So harvest is an important activity in our country. We grow crops, we cut them, and if the crop is good, we celebrate harvest festival. Sometimes we pray to God for the good yield of crops, and for that we celebrate these harvest festivals. So it is the time when a crop is sown, by the time it is ready for reaping, these festivals are celebrated. Okay, so let us know about some harvest festivals of the country. The first one is Bihu. Bihu is the harvest festival of Assam. Okay, so by the time when the crop is grown and it is cut down, Bihu festival is celebrated, and it is a festival of Assam. Special Bihu dancers perform Bihu dance on this festival. Okay, the next one is the festival celebrated among Sikhs. It is known as Baisakhi. It is celebrated on 13th April every year. The festival is mainly celebrated in North India, particularly in Punjab and Himachal Pradesh. So, Baisakhi is also a harvest festival, which is basically celebrated in the region Punjab and Himachal Pradesh. Okay. Then the next one is Onam. Onam is celebrated in Kerala. It is the festival that is celebrated in Kerala in the month of August and September. Okay. Special dishes, boat race, tiger dance, flower rangolis and martial arts are done on this day. A lot of delicious dishes are also prepared, which are served on banana leaves. Okay. The next one is the festival Pongal. Pongal is celebrated in the state Tamil Nadu. It is a festival of Tamilians. Pongal is the harvest festival of Hindu. It is a 3-day festival mainly celebrated in the month of January. Okay, in this festival, people of Tamil Nadu thank Sun God and Lord Indra for proper yield of crops. Okay, children. Okay, children, let us see what is given in your book. So, open to page number 36. Under the heading Festivals and Fun. So here you have to read the clues, and on the basis of the given clues you have to name the festival in these blocks. Okay, the first one, on this day we celebrate the king home. On this day we celebrate the homecoming of King Mahabali. We enjoy watching the snake boat races
We also eat delicious food on this day. So you can see a boat race is being performed. So the boat race are done in the festival Onam, which is a festival celebrated in Kerala, and it celebrates the homecoming of King Mahabali, who blesses the yield of crops every year. So the festival is Onam, O-N-A-M. Okay, the next one. On this day we celebrate the birth of and death anniversaries of our Sikh Gurus. We go to Gurudwara to offer our prayers to Gurus. So the festival is Guru Purab. Write the spelling. I have already explained what you do on Guru Purab. Gurpurab. Okay, so on this day, six gurus were born. So we celebrate Sikh gurus' death anniversary and birth anniversaries on Gurpurab. Okay, the next one. By seeing this Santa Claus, you already recognized which festival is this. Ho ho ho, I visit children with gifts and chocolates on this day every year. So this is the festival Christmas, C-H-R-I-S-T-M-A-S. This festival is celebrated as the birthday of Christians' God, Lord Christ or Jesus Christ. Okay, so there is a Christian celebrate the festival Christmas. The next one, you can see diyas and candles and crackers. This is the festival of light. We light diyas and candles on this day. So the festival is Diwali. D-I-W-A-L-I. Okay, the next one. As on this day, we give food and money to poor people. We break our month-long fast on this day. So this the festival is Eid, E-I-D, Eid ul-Fitr. Muslims keep this festival This festival is celebrated after keeping the fast of a month, followed by Eid ul-Fitr. Okay, the next one. We buy clothes to this festival. The best part is the yummy food. We celebrate this festival for 4 days. So this the festival, you can see the deity of goddess Durga over here. So this is Durga Puja. It is celebrated for 4 days, and the goddess, the idol Durga Puja, P-U-G-A, Durga Puja, goddess, the idol of Goddess Durga is kept at home or at various places, and various cultural activities are performed. People go and visit these pandals. Okay, so the festival is Durga Puja, D-U-R-G-A-P-U-G-A, Durga Puja. Okay, the next one is the festival of colors, and it is known as Holi. This day marks arrival of the spring season. We celebrate it with colors. So the Diwali is the festival of Holi is the festival of colors. Next one. This is a harvest festival celebrated to thank the sun god. We celebrate this day with food and flowers. So you can I have already explained that we thank sun god and Lord Indra in the festival Pongal. Okay, for the good yield of crops. Pongal is the festival celebrated by the people of Tamil Nadu. Okay, this completes your chapter.
Okay, children, let's come on to the next festival, which says, on this day we give food and money to poor people. We break our month-long fast on this day. So, it is the festival celebrated by Muslims and it is known as Eid. Okay, Eid ul Fitr is the full name of this festival, and Muslims celebrate this festival after keeping a fast of 1 month, and they break their fast on this day. On this day, they pray to their God by performing namaz at masjids and by hugging each other. A lot of delicious dishes including sevaiyan or sevai are prepared on this day. So the festival is Eid. The next one. We buy new clothes for this festival. The best part is the yummy food. We celebrate this festival for 4 days. So as you can see, the deity of goddess Durga. So it is the festival Durga Puja. It is mainly celebrated in West Bengal, but also it is the part of the most celebrated festival across the nation. So the festival is Durga Puja, where the idol of goddess Durga is worshipped for 4 days, and people visit various pandals perform Durga Puja and eat various delicious dishes on this day. Okay, so the festival is Durga Puja, D-U-R-G-A-P-U-J-A, Durga Puja. The next one, as you can see, a lot of colors. So, it is the festival of colors, Holi. Let's read what is given. This day marks the arrival of spring season. We celebrate it with colors. So, we celebrate the festival Holi with colors. The spelling is H-O-L-I. The last one. This is a harvest festival to thank the sun god. We celebrate this day with food and flowers. So, this festival is known as Pongal. P-O-N-G-A-L. Where goddess, god, sun and Lord Indra are thanked for the good yield of the crops. Pongal is mainly celebrated by the people of Tamil Nadu. Okay, so it is a regional festival where a lot of delicious dishes are prepared and people worship the god Sun and Lord Indra. This completes your chapter.